friends, welcome to the formula engineering classroom. And in this lecture of fluid kinematics, we will discuss the kinematic equation in differential form. Normally, when we are defining kinematic equation, so what is the sense of that term? So here I'm particularly defining the kinematic equation in differential form. So how can we analyze the things? How can we define the things when the fluid is continuous or not? And how we are saying that is divergence of velocity is defining the kinematic equation. We'll see all these things in this lecture. So let's suppose we are considering a fluid element. Or actually this is not element, this is propeller piped. So let's suppose this is X, this is Y, and this is Z direction. And we are considering a parallel piped. Okay, so this is a parallel piped. So the respective dimensions of this parallel piped. So in the X direction, we are saying this is DX. In the Y direction, we are saying this is DY. In the Z direction, we are saying this is DZ. So here, the volume of this parallel piped, we can say this is DX, DY, DZ. Okay, now, let we are considering this face. Okay, let I'm marking this one. Let's suppose this is A, B, C, and D. And let this is E, F, G, and H. So we are considering the face ABCD, okay, and in this case we are considering everything is varying. That is, we are saying the velocity is variable, the density is variable. So initially we are considering everything is varying in this case. So here we are considering that is how much mass of fluid entering in this parallel pipe through the face ABCD. So let's suppose in this case I'm saying the density I'm taking rho. The velocity in the x direction I am taking u, and the cross section area of this face, or simply the area of this face, you can say this is dy dz. So I am saying this is dy dz. Okay, so you can see here when I am writing that is rho u dy dz. So in this case I am simply saying that is rho, and we can write u as dx by dt, that is the velocity in x direction, then dy dz. Okay, so here rho is the density and dx, dy, dz is the volume. So density into volume is providing mass. Okay, so this is mass. Divide by dt, so this is providing mass flow rate. So this is the mass flow rate entering through the face ABCD. But let, if I am saying how much mass is entering through this face in the time interval dt. So if you want to calculate the amount of mass that is entering through this phase ABCD in the time interval dt, then we can simply multiply this equation by dt. So in that case, we are providing, or this whole term is providing, that how much mass is entering through the phase ABCD. So here I'm applying dt here. Okay, so this is the amount of mass that is entering through the phase ABCD. So the mass leaving through the phase EFGH in the time interval dt. So we can define this is rho u plus del, as density is going to change and velocity is going to be changed over the distance dx, into dx. And this is multiplied by dy dz dt. So this is the amount of mass leaving through the phase EFGH in the x direction in the time interval dt. Similarly, the mass of fluid entering through this phase in the time interval dt. So obviously in this case we are concerned about y direction. So in this case I'm writing this is, so let I'm changing my color here, my pen color here. So this is, I'm saying this is rho v. So v is the velocity in y direction, and here the area of this phase, that is ADHE, is simply dx dz. So this is dx dz. This is the mass flow rate. So in the time interval dt, so we are simply multiplying this one by dt. So this is the amount of mass that is entering through this phase ADHE in the y direction in the time interval dt. So the amount of mass leaving the phase BCGF in the y direction. So we can write this is rho v plus del. Rho is going to change, v is also going to change over del x into, sorry, this is dy, into dy, del y multiplied by dy, and area is dx dz, and in the time interval dt. Okay, now third we are saying, that is amount of mass entering through the phase BFEA. This is from back side, let we are saying this is from this side. Obviously we are concerned about in z direction in this case. So in this case we can write this is rho, w is the velocity in z direction, and here the area of this phase BFEA is simply dx dy, and we are concerned about in the time interval dt here. Okay, then mass leaving through the phase here, so we can write this is rho w plus del rho by del w over del z dz through the area dx dy in the time dt. Okay, so we consider all the phases here. Now let's check the equations. So first I am saying mass in x direction, mass in x direction. So I'm saying this is mass in, simply in x direction. So mass in is direction in time interval, in time dt. So we are saying this is simply rho u dy dz dt. Okay, then mass out in x direction in time dt. So we are saying this is rho u plus del rho u by del x dx dy dz dt. Okay, so what is the change in mass in x direction? So change in mass in x direction in time dt. So the change will be in minus out. So that is mass in minus mass out. That is mass in minus mass out. So from here we can write this equation. So we can write this is rho u dy dz dt minus rho u plus del rho u by del x dx dy dz dt. Okay, so now, so here the change will be equals to, so this term rho u dy dz dt is cancelled by rho u dy dz dt. So remaining term is minus del rho u by del x dy dz dt. Okay, let's suppose this is our equation 1 here. So this is the change in mass in x direction. Clear? Similarly, we can write change in mass in y direction. So similarly, we can write here that this is minus del rho v by del y multiplied by dx dy dz dt. So this is the change in mass in y direction. So change in mass similarly in z direction. So similarly we can write this is minus del rho w by del z dx dy dz dt. Actually, all these things are in time t. In time dt, sorry. In time dt. This is in time dt. Okay, so this is three equations. There is three equations. That is equation one. That is the change in mass in x direction in the time dt. That is this one. This is change in mass in the y direction time dt. That is this one. And similarly, the change in mass in z direction in time dt is this one. So from here we can analyze what is the total change in mass in the time interval dt. So I'm saying total change in mass. Total change in mass in time dt. Okay, so from here we can add them all three equations. So we can write minus, so this is del rho u by del x plus del rho v by del y plus del rho w by del z and multiplied by dx dy dz in time interval dt. So this is the total change in mass in the time interval dt. So now we can also say that there is this change in mass through the parallel pipe in the time interval dt will be equals to the total change in mass within the parallel pipe in the same time interval. Okay, because this is the incoming and outgoing simply. So we are adding this one. So we can say that, I'm repeating again, we can say that this total change in mass in the time interval dt will also be equals to change in mass within the parallel pipe. Okay, or within the control volume system, because in that case the volume is controlled, the volume is fixed, that is dx dy dz. Okay, so we can say that is, we can either change in mass in time dt within the system. So we can write this will be equals to del m by del t. This is a gradient of mass change in the time interval dt, del t multiplied by dt. So this is the change in mass within the system in the time interval dt. So we can replace this term m here by the use of density and volume. So we can write this one, that is like del rho by del t, that is density here, dx dy dz is the volume here, so this is the mass multiplied by dt. So this is the change in mass within the system in the time interval dt here. Obviously in this case, if let's suppose we are saying this is our equation A and this is our equation B, in that case the both will be same here, so we can equate them. So let, I'm writing here, so this is, I'm saying that is equation A, equation, sorry, I'm saying equation A is equals to equation B. So I'm equating here, so I'm writing this is minus del rho u by del x plus del rho v by del y plus del rho w by del z multiplied by dx dy dz dt equals to this term, that is del rho by del t dx dy dz dt. Okay, so from equating this one, we can say this term is cancelled out with this term here. So the remaining terms, we can write like that, that is minus del rho u by del x plus del rho v by del y plus del rho w by del z equals to del rho by del t. Okay, so now we can open these terms. First of all, we can write this term like that, that is del rho by del t. I'm taking this side, so this is also a negative sign. It's also a negative sign, so equals to, the whole term is going to equal to 0. So I'm taking this as positive here. This is positive del rho u by del x plus del rho v by del y plus del rho w by del z equals to 0 in this case. Okay, now we can open this term. So we can write del rho by del t plus, so I'm differentiating with respect to u first, then I'm differentiating with respect to rho. Okay, I'm open simply this term. So similarly, this is del v by del y, then v del rho by del y, then we can write rho del w by del z, then w del rho by del z. Okay, so let's rearrange this equation, and we can write this is del rho by del t plus, so in all three terms I am taking the rho common here, so I can write rho del u by del x plus del v by del y plus del w by del z, then plus u del rho by del x v del rho by del y w del rho by del z and equals to 0. So guys, this is the general equation of continuity which is valid for compressible, incompressible, steady, unsteady, uniform, non-uniform, one-dimensional, two-dimensional and three-dimensional flow. So this is the generalized form. Okay, and this is valid for all type or all kind of flows, because in this case you can see here the density is a variable function, here the velocity is a variable function, density is varying with respect to the space coordinate, here the density is varying with the time coordinate. So all these things, so means this is the general form of the quantity equation that is valid. Guys, as you are preparing for the IES 2018 exam that is going to be conducted on January 7, 2018, and so we have almost left 3 months roughly, so I will make a video, so how can you prepare for your IES prelim exam in the best possible way in this time duration. So stay with me. So in the next lecture I will tell you how can you prepare in the 3 months for your IES pre-examination in the best possible way, and you can crack it. Okay, so now we are moving next year. So let's suppose in this case, if I'm saying the flow is steady, so I'm saying first condition I'm taking, flow is steady. So when the flow is steady, then the properties are not going to change with respect to time. So we can say that here the term del rho by del t is going to be 0 in this case. So we can say del rho by del t is going to be 0 here. Okay. Now, second, if I'm saying flow is incompressible. Flow is incompressible. In that case, when the flow is incompressible, then density is not going to be changed here. So in that case, the density change with respect to x, y and z, all terms are going to be 0. So here we can say that there is del rho by del x equals to del rho by del y equals to del rho by del z is equals to 0 in this case. So after imposing these two conditions, we can write the above equation in this form. That is, we can write this is del u by del x plus del v by del y plus del w by del z and equals to 0. So this is the form of continuity equation, and it is only valid for steady incompressible flow. This form is only valid for steady incompressible flow because we are imposing these two conditions, and this is also valid for one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional flow. So this is also, this is, we can say this is for 3D system. So for 2D we can say the term will be like that. This is del rho by del x plus del v by del y equals to 0, because the term with respect to z is going to be 0. So this is for 2D system, or this is for 2D steady incompressible flow. And the term del u by del x equals to 0, and this is valid for one dimensional, or this is for one dimensional steady incompressible flow. Okay, now let's check the vector form of this equation. So I'm using this space here. So I'm taking this equation here. So I'm rewriting this one here. So this is del u by del x plus del u by del y plus del w by del z equals to 0 here. So that we are breaking this term, and we can rewrite this equation like that. We can write this is del by del x I cap plus del by del y j cap plus del by del z k cap, and this is a dot product of u I v j and w k equals to 0. So this term, you know what is this term is, this term is actually del, or grade we can define this as. So this is del dot, this we know this is the velocity v, because we can write v equals to ui plus vj plus wk equals to 0. So this is the vector form of this contrary equation, that is del dot v. Or the del dot v is also defined as divergence of v. So actually divergence of v is, we are defining quantity equation in this case when we are saying divergence of v is equals to 0. So when the divergence of v, or velocity vector field, is 0, in that case that flow will be continuous flow, and that flow should be steady and incompressible in that case. So means if you are not getting divergence of v not equals to 0, then that flow is not continuous flow. Okay, in that case the divergence of v either positive or negative, means that either in that case the velocity field is going to be diverge or it going to be converge, but in that case the flow is not continuous in that case. So when we are saying divergence of v is 0, in that case we can say that that is the flow, or steady and incompressible flow will always be a continuous flow. Okay, hope you are enjoying the videos. So guys, to support this channel, please like the videos, subscribe the channel, and tell your friend to subscribe the channel, and ask your doubts in comment section, and please share the knowledge as much as you can, and best of luck for your coming exams. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Thanks a lot again.